free energy changes for the reaction, these are very, very important as far as the thermodynamics of the reaction is concerned. Are you getting it? So you should know how to calculate the free energy of the reaction. We know that it is the free energy of the product minus the free energy of the reactants. What is free energy? What do you mean by free energy? The energy which is available with the reactant to perform the particular reaction. It is an inherent ability of the reaction to undergo product formation. Are you getting it? That is known as free energy. So when we talk about any catalysis or the biocatalysis, we should remember one thing, that this catalyst or the biocatalyst, ye yaad rakh lo, dimag mein fit kar lo, it will never influence the free energy of the reaction. It will never influence the free energy of the reaction. What it will influence? It will influence the energy of activation. They will influence the energy of activation. What is energy of activation? What is the difference between the free energy and energy of activation? Minimum amount of energy that the reactant must cross in order to form the transition state. Any reactions, whether it is an enzyme catalyzed reaction or the chemical reaction. For example, A plus B to C. This reaction takes place in two steps actually. First of all, the A plus B, it will form the transition state, that is AB, and from AB the final product C is being formed. So the energy which is required to form this AB, that is the transition state, is known as the energy of activation. Are you getting it? So whatever the enzymes or the catalyst will do, they will reduce this energy of activation so that transition state can be easily formed. Are you getting it? In the absence of the catalyst, this reaction will be very slow otherwise, and this will be very fast. But the difficulty is the formation of the transition state. So how the formation of the transition state is possible? When you lower the energy of activation. Suppose you have appeared in exam paper 1. Are you getting it? You have prepared for that particular exam for 2 hours and you scored 29 marks out of 30. 1 week after, again you have appeared in the examination. You have prepared for 2 hours but now you have got 40 marks. What is the reason? You have not increased your efforts. Wo paper tha wo aasan tha pehle wale paper se. That's why you could have improved your performance. Similarly here, what enzymes or the biocatalyst will do? They will reduce the energy of activation and they will allow the formation of the transition state. So what is the relationship between the enthalpy and the entropy? What is enthalpy? What is enthalpy? Yes, what do you mean by enthalpy? You should know the relationship between the free energy, enthalpy and entropy, delta. The enthalpy is actually the total amount of heat which the system possesses. The total amount of heat which the system possesses. So what is the difference of the heat between the system and the external environment? That is symbolized by delta H. Are you getting it? That is your enthalpy. Delta G is the free energy and delta S is difference in the entropy between the system and the external environment. Are you getting it? So if for any reaction, if you know the enthalpy difference and the entropy difference, you should be able to calculate what is the free energy difference of that reaction. Are you getting it? So this is the equation which you should know. Now the standard free energy change, it means at temperature 25 degree centigrade and with the equimolar concentration of the different reactant, whatever the free energy of the reaction is, that free energy is known as standard free energy. So how it can be used to calculate the free energy? This is the equation. Iske upar example puche jate hain. Delta G is equal to delta G 0 dash plus 2.303 RT log into Q. This reflects the concentration of product, ratio of Q reflects the concentration of the product to that of the concentration of the reactants. Are you getting it? Yahan pe zero kyun likha hai? Because this is under the ideal conditions. When temperature is 25 degrees centigrade or the reactants are in their equimolar concentration. At that point of time, whatever the free energy which we are measuring, it is symbolized at delta G. So how this can be calculated? When all the concentration will be in the equimolar condition, when the system will achieve the equilibrium? When the system will achieve the equilibrium. So if I want to calculate now the delta G, it can be calculated by this particular equation, that is minus RT 2.303 RT log K equilibrium. Equilibrium constant can be calculated by this particular equation. So you should be aware about all these equations, the question can be asked. Okay. Another important point is bioenergetics, glycolysis, oxidative phosphorylation, coupled reaction, group transfer, biological energy transducer. So you should know what are the energy producing and energy utilizing system. You know that majority of the anabolic pathways, they are energy utilizing system, and catabolic pathways, they are energy producing system. So you should know the stoichiometry. You should know the stoichiometry. What is the relationship between the biomolecule which is being oxidized or which is being metabolized and energy is being formed? Are you getting it? For example, if 1 mole of glucose, if 1 mole of glucose is oxidized anaerobically, how much ATP it will produce? It will produce 2 ATPs. It will produce 2 ATPs, that is only through the substrate level phosphorylation, because oxidative phosphorylation does not take place because the electron acceptor and electron donor is same when the anaerobic respiration takes place. Are you getting it? So the question can be asked that if the bacteria is metabolizing the glucose by under the anaerobic condition, how much amount of glucose will be required to produce 30 or 32 grams of moles of ATP, which is being produced generally under the aerobic condition? Now we know that under the anaerobic condition only 2 ATPs are being produced, that is only due to the substrate level phosphorylation in two different steps, 1,3-diphosphoglycerate to 3-phosphoglycerate and 2-phosphoenolpyruvate to pyruvate in the glycolysis. So if 1 mole of glucose can produce 2 ATPs, then we need 18 moles of glucose in order to produce 36 ATPs. Are you getting it? And this effect is known as under the anaerobic condition, the requirement of sugar is increased for the organism, and this effect is known as pasture effect. This effect is known as pasture effect, that under the anaerobic condition, the requirement for the sugar is increased for the organism. Are you getting it? It requires, you can say, a 15 to 16 times more sugar than that of those bacteria which are metabolizing the same sugar under aerobic condition. Are you getting it? So the modes of ATP generation, you should know there are three different modes by and large. Which are the three major different modes of ATP generation? One is the substrate level phosphorylation, second is the oxidative phosphorylation, and third is photophosphorylation, which is found during the photosynthesis. Are you getting it? So you should have thorough understanding regarding the substrate level phosphorylation, where there is a no involvement of electron transport chain. When there is a no involvement of electron transport chain, the photophosphorylation. Are you getting it? Generally, photophosphorylation is observed in both bacteria as well as in plant. In case of the bacteria, it is observed in green sulfur as well as the purple sulfur bacteria. But what is the difference? The difference between the plant and the bacteria is that bacteria does not have photosystem too. Plant have the photosystem too. Are you getting it? So that's why whatever the photosynthesis which is being observed in the bacteria, that will be anoxygenic photosynthesis. That will be anoxygenic mode of photosynthesis. Cytochrome BC1 complex is also there during the photophosphorylation. Are you getting it? It will serve the same purpose which is being served by the complex 3 in your electron transport chain. And when the electron transport takes place in that particular region, you will have the formation of the ATP. So, what are the different stages in the electron transport chain where the free energy is being released and trapped in the form of the ATP? Which are those three sites where the ATP formation takes place? One is from the complex 1 to the ubiquinone, second is in complex 3, and third is in complex 4. Third is in complex 4. Mind well that here these three are the sites of ATP synthesis. They are this does not indicate that yahan pe ek ATP hoga, yahan pe ek ATP hoga, yahan pe ek ATP hoga, aisa nahi hai. These are just merely the site of the ATP synthesis. Now, how many ATPs are produced? That will depend upon how many protons are being pumped out from the inner mitochondrial membrane space to the matrix. If we talk about the complex one, there are 4 protons which are being pumped out from the inner mitochondrial membrane space to matrix. If we talk about the complex 3, again 4, and if we talk about the complex 4, it is 2. So when the NADH will transfer its electron to the oxygen, it will produce, it will pump out 10 protons from the inner mitochondrial membrane to the matrix. Now, in order to synthesize one ATP, how many protons are required? How many protons are required? 4 protons are required. How many protons are required? 4. Now, how many protons are being pumped out when NADH gives their electron to the oxygen? 10. So, once the NADH will transfer its electron to the oxygen, it will produce 2.5 ATPs. 2.5 NADH, 2.5, and FADH, it will bypass the complex 1. It will directly give its electron to the complex 2. So, complex 1 ka jo ATP tha, wo bypass ho gaya. To uske jo 4 electron the, wo bypass ho gaye. So, if there is a flavoproteins FAD or FAMN which are being involved, which are direct succinate dehydrogenase catalyzed reaction, for example, giving electrons directly to the ubiquinone, the coenzyme Q. So, complex 1 is being bypassed. So, now how many electrons? 6 electrons. Because jo complex 1 mein 4 electrons ban rahe the, uska advantage yahan pe nahi milega. So, 6 electrons will be there. So, when FAD will give its electron to the oxygen, 1.5 ATPs are being formed. So, in the new Leninger, this kind of calculation is given. But if you go by the old Leninger with a blue or black cover page, they have 36 or 38 ATP, whatever is there, depending upon the kind of shuttle operated. So, you go by the new Leninger, jo red color ka jiska cover page hai, you go by that Leninger, jiske andar ye naya calculation diya hua hai in all the metabolic pathways. Membrane structure and transport, you should know. Are you getting it? That what are the different types of the mode of transfer, nutrient transfer? Simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, active transport, whatever it may be, that you should know. So, types and thermodynamics of the membrane transport is very also very important. In enzymology, you should know what are the principles of catalysis, properties of the enzyme, enzyme and enzyme kinetics. Very important. Whatever the numericals which are based on the MM equation. You know MM equation, right? V0 is equal to Vmax into S upon Km plus S. V0 is equal to Vmax into S. On Km plus S. So, if you know this equation, koi aisa nahi puchega ki isko derive karo. Wo BSc mein pucha gaya aapko. Now, nobody will ask you. They will ask you that if the initial velocity is 20% of the maximum velocity, what will be the substrate concentration? Calculate. If the initial velocity is 20% of the maximum velocity, what will be the substrate concentration? Or they can ask you that if the substrate concentration is 4 times less than that of the Km value of the enzyme, what will be the velocity? What will be the velocity? So you should be able to calculate these kind of reaction. They will give you an enzyme catalyzed reaction. We know that Km is made up of 3 rate constants after the modification by Briggs and Haldane. There are 2 assumptions. One is the equilibrium assumption. Second is the steady state assumption. So on the basis of steady state assumption, we know that Km is made up of 3 rate constants. Km is equal to K2 plus K minus 1 upon K1. So for any reaction, if the rate of the reaction is given for each different steps, you should be able to calculate K2, you should be able to calculate K minus 1, you should be able to calculate K1. What is K1? Suppose if this is the enzyme catalyzed reaction, this is K1, this is K minus 1, and this is K2. मैंने आपको बताया कि रेट कांस्टेंट कैसे कैलकुलेट कर रहा है, वेलोसिटी अपॉन द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट. आर यू गेटिंग इट? सो इफ यू नो द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट, इफ यू नो द रेट ऑफ द रिएक्शन, दैट इज द वेलोसिटी, यू विल बी एबल टू कैलकुलेट के वन, के माइनस वन एंड के टू. फ्रॉम दैट यू कैन कैलकुलेट द के एम, बिकॉज के एम इज मेड अप ऑफ के टू, के माइनस वन एंड के वन, वेयर के टू एंड के माइनस वन दे आर द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रेट कॉन्स्टेंट एंड के वन इज द सेकंड ऑर्डर रेट कॉन्स्टेंट. Are you getting it? So you can calculate this directly. Samajh mein aaya? Okay, from this they can tell you what is the turnover number of the enzyme. They can ask you how you will calculate the turnover number of the enzyme. Now this K2, that is equivalent to kcat, because kcat will tell you the story after the formation of the ES complex, that once the substrate will bind to the enzyme, how fast the product formation takes place. That will be measured by the kcat. Kcat will not tell you that what will be the affinity of the substrate towards the enzyme. That will be by the Km. Are you getting it? So on this basis, you can be asked, you may be given the set of the substrates with the kcat and Km value, and you will be asked that out of these different substrates, which substrate will be catalyzed, utilized more efficiently by the enzyme. So in that case, you should neither depend upon kcat nor upon Km. You should depend upon the ratio of kcat by Km. That is the specificity constant, because Km will only tell you the story before the interval. Are you getting it? Interval se pehle ka story Km batata hai, lekin interval ke baad kya hoga wo Km nahi batata hai. वो कौन बताता है? केकेट. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेजर द एंटायर रेंज ऑफ द सब्सट्रेट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द एंजाइम कैटलाइज रिएक्शन, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेजर द एफिशियंसी ऑफ द एंजाइम, यू हैव टू टेक द रेशियो. वो आप लोग आपको टेबल दे देंगे, आपको डेटा दे देंगे, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट. यू शुड नॉट कम टू द कंक्लूजन जस्ट बाय मेजरिंग द केकेट और जस्ट बाय लुकिंग एट द केएम. यू जस्ट हैव टू टेक द रेशियो. जिसका रेशियो सबसे हाइएस्ट होगा, दैट सबस्ट्रेट विल बी यूटिलाइज मोर एफिशियंटली बाई दैट पर्टिक्यूलर एंजाइम. ऑन द एंजाइम मैकेनिज्म, मेनली 2 एंजाइम्स लिख लो, इसका मैकेनिज्म पढ़ के जाना. काइमोट्रिप्सिन एंड लाइसोजाइम, जो आपने एमएससी में पढ़ा होगा, काइमोट्रिप्सिन एंड लाइसोजाइम. यू प्रिपेयर द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ दीज 2 एंजाइम्स वेरी थरली, बिकॉज क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड. And on the enzyme purification, you should be asked to calculate the fold purification. You may be asked to calculate the specific activity of the enzyme. Conformation of protein, this we have already discussed. Ramachandran plot, secondary, tertiary and quaternary structures. See, in the protein, only the quaternary structure has the covalent bond. And the primary structure, peptide bond is the secondary, and tertiary structure, it has hydrogen and ionic bonds. For example, disulfide linkage is an example of covalent linkage. It is a covalent bond. So secondary, tertiary and quaternary structure, domain motifs and folds. Are you getting it? For example, helix, turn, helix motif. Kisme dekhne ko milta hai? which kind of protein have these kind of protein fold? DNA binding protein. For example, helix turn helix protein, leucine zipper proteins. Are you getting it? So you should know about the different domains, motifs and folds of the protein. Methods of structure determination, X-ray crystallography, NMR, LC-MS. Are you getting it? These are the different methods for the structure determination of the protein and the methods for determining the end terminal sequences. Methods for determining the end terminal sequences. For example, the use of diencyl chloride. Are you getting it? In order to find out the end terminal sequence of the particular amino acid. Protein structure database and tools. In silico analysis, aap kaise kar sakte ho? What are the protein database tools which are available? If you want to artificially or in silico analysis se aapko find out karna hai, what are the databases available? Brother, that you should know. These all are the information based question. See, domain will be present even in the tertiary and quaternary structure of the proteins. Now what will happen, that's for example, suppose this is one domain of the protein, this is the second domain of the protein. If I will further fold it, further bend it, it will become motif or it will become the fold. Are you getting it? So the particular portion of the protein which has some extra configuration which will help them to get access to other biomolecules. Jaise maine aapko bataya helix turn helix motif, pura protein mein wo structure nahi hota hai. Are you getting it? Protein ka jo portion DNA ke sath interact karta hai, wo helix turn helix motif ke swaroop mein hota hai. Are you getting it? So that particular region, that particular portion of the protein. Brother. So if we look at the structure of the protein, primary, secondary, tertiary, tertiary proteins has different domains and some of the domains have particular motifs and the folds. Are you getting it? For example, the leucine zipper or helix turn helix is a motif. It is not acquired by that entire protein, but some particular domain of that protein which will acquire this particular conformation so that it can have access to the DNA or the any other biomolecules. Now as far as the nucleic acid is concerned, the DNA structure and base composition, they may ask you that if in any particular DNA, if it contains 50% of adenine, what will be the concentration of guanine in that DNA molecule? What will be the concentration of guanine in that DNA molecule? If any DNA contains 50% of the adenine, what will be the concentration of the guanine? What will be the proportion of guanine? You know the Chergoff's rule? Then how 50%? 0%. 0%. 50% adenine hai, 50% thymine hoga hi, as per the Chergoff's rule, A is equal to T, C is equal to G. So 0%. Are you getting it? Mahabharat ma apne Mahabharat aapko pata hai na? In Mahabharat, agar main aapko aisa puchu ki bhai Mata Kunti ne kitla putra hota, tame pehla kesa Panda ho, etle panch j hoy na ave. Ha, pachi Karna pan je chha, par pachi yaad aave ke na na apne Nakul ne Sahadev to Madri na putra hota, etle char. This is the correct answer, that is 4. Are you getting it? So you should have the patience to not only read the question but to understand the question. Sometime you may find in the competitive exam that the questions will be like in the form of the paragraphs, but the answer will be very easy if you read the question carefully. And some questions are very, very short but difficult to solve. Are you getting it? I have kept some those kind of questions in your question paper. Are you getting it? So forms of the DNA, DNA supercoiling, you should know about the linking number. Topoisomerase 1 and topoisomerase. What is linking number? Topoisomerase 1 and topoisomerase 2. Linking number is ketla word utare che DNA na hai. Jo ek j word utar to hoy DNA no. Brother. So ene kevay reduction of DNA supercoiling by linking number 1. Jo ek bhi word utar to hoy ek saath hai. To ene su kevay linking number 2. So topoisomerase 1 ne 2 ko ne adhare classification thayu che. It is based on the linking number. How much turns it can unfold or it can introduce when it will undergo super coiling, either one or two. If one, then topoisomerase one. If two, then topoisomerase two. So denaturation kinetics, what cause? Mutation and DNA repair, RNA structure, transcription and processing. They may ask you that if I have the DNA with the length of 5000 base pairs, what will be the length of this DNA? How will you calculate this? I have the DNA of 5000 base pairs, right? I want to find out what will be the length of the DNA. How will you calculate? By considering that the DNA is of B form. How will you calculate? So you have to find out that in one turn of the DNA, 10 or 10.4 or 10.5, whatever, we will consider 10 base pairs are there in one helical turn. So in that size of that 10 base pair is 0.34 nanometer. So if 10 base pairs has the size of 0.34 nanometer, what about 5000? You can calculate. Brother, vice versa is also possible. So all these different kinds of questions can be asked. So now, this was the last slide actually. Now I will give you the question paper. You solve the question paper and in the next session we will discuss the answers.